What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Great to see you again. Today's topic is one of the most misunderstood, or maybe the one which is always confused with each other. Yes. Today we are going to discuss what is the difference between love and attachment. If you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. It's been a while since I've been saying this statement because I was off from making videos for around 7 days. And today, what's the date today? Today is 16th January, 8:30 p.m. Germany time. And now I have started making the videos again. Finally, I'm back. So I'll be responding to your comments which you have given in the past week videos, in the videos of the weekends. I'm very happy to see so many people appreciating the videos which I had made. All right, if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website, and please do not mail me unnecessarily, because recently somebody mailed me, and then because I did not reply to their mail, then that person went and disliked all the 300 videos which I have in my channel. So I was like, oh, okay. So I didn't give her a free reading, a free consultation. That is why you go and dislike all the 300 videos. Well, if that is what you want to do, then you're most welcome to do. You can keep disliking my future videos also. I can't help it. If that is how you react, that is how you spread venom. All right. And before I begin, as I always say, and today I must say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will be there, and he will help you understand the difference between these two words, love and attachment. So in the scriptures, there is a saying in Bengali. Krishner Indriya Priti Vancha Tare Bolo Prem. Atme Indriya Priti Vancha Tare Bolo Kam. What is the difference between lust and love? This video is on attachment and love, but for that we have to understand what is lust. Lust grossly translates into sexual desire, but that's not the case. This statement from one of the holy books means that whenever we want to satisfy our own senses, that itself is lust. And whenever we want to satisfy God, that itself is original love. That is the ultimate form of love. All right. But when we talk of love in this material world, what is the difference between love and attachment? That we have to understand. Love basically means, should I repeat, love is simply when you want to make the other person happy. Should I repeat, love is simply when you make the other person happy, when you want to see the other person happy, irrespective of your situation. That is love. When you just want to make that other person feel good, happy, blissful, joyous, joyful, lovely. That's the love which a mother has for her child. Now, attachment means you want the other person to make you happy. That is attachment. Should I repeat? Attachment means you want that that person should come and give you happiness. Yes? That is the difference between love and attachment. That is why the love of this material world between a man and a woman is bound to undergo frustration. Why? Because the love which they have is tainted with expectation. Should I repeat? The love which they have is tainted with expectation. The moment a boy or a girl stops fulfilling the desires, wishes of each other, two people will separate. That's it. Enough of the love romance. We are enemies now. Because why have you separated? The only reason because you have separated is you don't scratch my back, I don't scratch your back. Now, I don't cater to your needs, neither do you cater to mine. Yes? That means we can't stay together anymore. That means the love which you had for each other, the so-called love, was tainted with attachment, expectation. Means although you wanted to make the other person happy, you also wanted that the other person make you happy. And that is why we see in this day and age of Kali Yuga, in countries like India, America, Australia, relationships are collapsing at such a high frequency. It is like it's impossible to delineate now. And especially for astrologers, it becomes even more difficult, because sometimes people come and tell me that, oh, I have had 12 relationships in the past. Can you tell me about my 13th relationship? I said, I'm sorry. I can't say that. I don't know how to see 13th relationship, alright? The point is not how many relationships has anybody gone through. The point is, why are relationships falling apart? Because people are expecting more and more and more in return from the others. That is why love, or the love of this world, which is tainted with expectation, is getting frustrated. Because Lord Krishna says in the Gita that when lust is unfulfilled, it turns into anger. Have you seen people getting angry sometimes? Or have we experienced getting angry? When do we get angry? When something does not go the way we want them to go, right? We wanted to go in this bus. This bus is late. Oh my God, I am so angry. Or maybe in Germany, the bus is before time sometimes. But either ways, I miss the bus. So I'm angry. So then I get angry because I thought that the bus should function as per my wish, right? Everything in this world should revolve as I want. That is the problem. That is where you suffer. So the point is, how to differentiate between love and attachment. Love is when you want to give happiness. Attachment is when you want to take happiness. So the moment you expect something in return from somebody else, that's it. The love is becoming lower and lower, because now you are getting attached to the person. Attachment simply means that you cannot stay without that person making you happy, right? That is what is attachment. Love is beautiful. Love is everlasting. It is joyous. It gives you a lot of fulfillment. But attachment is very painful. So we have to understand that we cannot be attached to somebody. We have to be in love with somebody, not attached. But the question is, how to be attached? How to be in love without being attached, right? That's very difficult. The answer is very simple. When you yourself are so much happy inside, then only that is possible. Otherwise, forget it. People have tried millions of lifetimes. It doesn't work. The moment you become unhappy, the other person will also become unhappy. Have you ever tried staying with a person who is unhappy? Miserable, right? And then the question is, how to be happy? The answer is very simple. To the degree we find happiness in material objects, boy, girl, man, woman, male, female, money, wine, pornography, prostitution, Game of Thrones, this, that, we will be continually frustrated. So if we want to stop that frustration so that we can give happiness to somebody who is staying with us, we have to look towards Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityurma Sadgamaya. We have to look towards God, who can give us the highest level of fulfillment. Otherwise, we will remain frustrated in this world. Just see the life of any materialistic person going to the office in the morning, frustrated. Oh, I don't like my job. Coming to the home, again, his wife is shouting, he's frustrated there also. How miserable the life of a materialistic person can get. Of course, there can be certain avenues where you are happy. Like somebody is getting married, then you are happy for no reason. Especially in India, I have seen. Oh, somebody else gets married and that person becomes happy. Oh yeah, very good, he's getting married. Hey, what are you getting? No. You are just happy to get some spicy masala cooked up news, right? That's what keeps you going in life. So, if you want to be happy, then we have to go closer towards what the Srimad Bhagavatam says. Raso Vaisaha, the absolute truth, God, Lord Vishnu, is the epitome. He is the reservoir of all pleasure. Rasa Vaisaha, he is like the unlimited ocean. Yes, and God only sees the good that we do to him. So we have to focus on our spiritual journey by which we can gain happiness by staying. Because see, the moment you touch an electric socket, if that has electricity, what happens? You get a jerk, right? Because you are connecting to a source which has something which you don't have. So the moment you connect yourself to God, who is the source of happiness, that moment itself you become very happy. That is why you see spiritual people, sadhus, great enlightened sannyasis, beings, or even if they are married, who are spiritually connected, always happy. You will never see them miserable, crying, cribbing, complaining, criticizing. Never. So you will always see their faces blissful. They have no worries because they know that God is there with them all the time and they are seeing God all the time. Yes. So that is the difference between love and attachment and how to love somebody by not being attached. Because to the degree we are attached to somebody, when they leave us, we will have pain, we will have sorrow, suffering, tears, misery, my God. And to the degree we love somebody, to that degree we will find happiness and they will also find happiness in us. Yes. So love everybody, do not kill anybody by being attached. The difference between Vidura and Dhritarashtra in Mahabharata was, Vidura loved Dhritarashtra, but Dhritarashtra was attached to Duryodhana. Yes. So if some of you know the story of Vidura and Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana, then let me see, please let me know in the comments. Let me see how much of the Mahabharata do my subscribers know. Alright, so that is it from my side. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you want a consultation, then approach me through my website below. And that is it. I hope that you love others, or at least you find people who love you. Okay? If you don't, then contact me. Bye-bye. See you. We'll be right back.